if you want to go for a regular ECG just to be sure about things are okay with your heart, etc., how often should one do? And is ECG enough, or do you need to take a higher level or like a stress test or any other test? And how often should you keep doing your ECG just to check if things are in control?
Very good question, ma'am. Actually, see, whenever a person is experiencing chest pain for the first time in his lifetime, it is better he gets the ECG as early as possible and consults the doctor regarding the diagnosis. Once we are sure the ECG is absolutely normal, but the symptoms are recurrent, the symptoms seem to be typical, and there are risk factors in a particular person who is experiencing the chest pain, so we advise 2D echo if the ECG is normal. So 2D echo again tells us about the function of the heart, whether there is any damage to the muscles of the heart. And if 2D echo is also normal, then we go on to do the stress test. Stress test is basically the person is connected with the leads, which records the ECG, and the person has to run on the treadmill. There are protocols to do the treadmills or TMT. Every 3 minutes, the speed increases and the incline also increases. It tests the endurance or the physical capacity of the patient, and we see whether the chest pain is getting recurred or is seen when the person is exerting himself with monitored situation. We are monitoring the person with the BP, with the ECG, and if we feel there are any abnormalities with the symptoms or there are ECG changes, we stop the test and the patient lies down. If required, we hospitalize also for monitoring. So stress test is done with proper monitoring. We give the stress and see whether the patient develops the symptoms and whether there are any changes in the ECG. The ECG changes again can be categorized into low risk, moderate risk and high risk. If the person is having high risk changes, then patient needs further investigation with angiography. So it is a step-by-step process of diagnosis. Not all the patients are subjected to angiography, but whenever we find that there is a high risk feature seen on a particular test, whether it is ECG, then 2D echo or stress test, the person will require medical therapy along with that coronary angiography. And if we are suspecting strongly with ECG and typical symptoms, we ask them to do some blood test for cardiac enzymes. Cardiac enzymes are CKMB or troponins, which tell us whether the person is already suffering from minor or major damage of the muscles because of the ischemia that develops in coronary artery disease.